Hey guys, welcome back, it's AmBigZero, and I'm here to show you how to create what you see here. This is a virtual Nintendo DS. This is a Nintendo DS emulator. And what that is, it is literally all the code and software from a Nintendo DS. It's almost exactly the same, just formatted for your computer. And the games are actually ROMs, and if you don't know what a ROM is, it's literally the game hooked up to a computer, and they just pull off the information. And the only difference is sometimes they format it differently, or literally the emulator can run the Nintendo DS software. If you don't understand what I'm saying, just kind of skip ahead from this part. But basically, if you want to dumb it down a little bit, it's exactly the same game for your computer. And there's no difference except it's a little bit laggier because it's trying to read a different format. So let me show you what I got here. I'll show you, so far I have three games. I got, as you can see in here, I have, obviously, Super Mario Brothers, which I was just playing. I have Yoshi's Touch and Go, and Super Mario 64, which all run, semi-perfectly. So let me, show you how this is done. First, what you're going to need is an emulator, which is the software that runs the games, and I'll post a link to all this stuff in the description. But basically on this site, about halfway down the page, you're gonna see this download for Windows, and you're gonna click that, and it's going to allow you to download the Nintendo DS, the virtual DS, not the games. So what you do is you just click on it, and if you have Firefox, this window's gonna pop up, and you would just press OK, save to disk. But I'm not going to because I already have this. You go ahead. If you have Internet Explorer, something similar is going to happen. I'm sorry, I don't know exactly what because I don't remember. I haven't used it in forever. But basically, after you you get your emulator all installed and extracted, you're going to see all of these weird files. Just ignore them. Make your own folder and just call it the emulator folder and put all the stuff inside. Basically, you don't even need to touch half this stuff. But it's useless right now anyway because you don't have a game. So let's just go get a game, and I'll show you how to do this. Okay, hold on. Okay, so next we're going to go to this site that a couple of friends of mine showed me, where you can get some ROMs for DS games. There's basically every DS game that ever came out, including some ones from Japan that we don't have here. And yes, they are in Japanese. But what I'm going to do, and by the way, I will post this in the description. I'll post all the links in a mini tutorial. But I'm going to get Mario Kart DS because I do not have that yet, and I remember it for Nintendo 64, and it was awesome. So we're gonna get that, and I'll show you how to download it and stuff like that. So you're gonna find your game, and you're gonna click on it, and you're going to go to Source 2 because RapidShare sucks if you download as much as I do. If you don't, RapidShare is fine and might be even faster. But if you go to Source 2, which you would have seen in that bar down there, you're going to come here, and you're going to press Free Download. It's loading a little slowly because of the videotaping. Sorry about that. Okay, so then it's going to scroll down. It's going to have you enter in this little code to make sure you're not some sort of robot or whatever. I don't know why. You just have to do it. And you press Submit, and press Begin Download. And then your little download window is going to come up, and you're going to save it. I'm not going to make you wait through this whole download because it does take a good amount of time, not too long, but it's, you know, it's okay. So I will just show you with some games that I already have. Okay, so after you get your game, there's a couple more things you're going to need to know about, is what file it was in. On your DS, depending on like the engine they used to run the game, the graphics, and some of the other stuff, it's saved as a different file, and you need to be able to read each different one. So you have to tell your emulator which file it's from. So you're going to look up your game. I looked up Mario Kart DS, and it's going to tell you the file type in this description here. This whole description tells you all about the game, what its name, when it was released, and stuff like that. But we're not interested in any of that. But down here at the bottom, it will tell you your file type, what it's saved as. Right here. So you're just going to have to remember what that says, and I'll show you how we use that later, and that is very important, so you must always get that, or else you will get an error message when you try to play the game. So let me show you how this is done. You are going to go find your emulator, the one that I had you download before. You're going to press this like thing that looks like an A. And it's going to open up your emulator, and then it's going to ask you which game you want to play. And I'm going to show you with Super Mario Brothers, because that's pretty much my favorite one out of the ones I have. And we're going to open that up. And because I didn't tell it what file type it was, we are going to get this error message that says that the save data could not be read, blah, 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 blah. It's crap that we don't need to know about. But, I will just... Oh, look at that. Okay, never mind. I will show you Mario Kart DS because it just finished. So, just give me a second to extract this and put a little game file in here for it. I'm going to create a new folder and name it Mario Kart DS. Let me drag my game in there and extract here. Okay, here we go. So here's our NDS file, Nintendo DS. And that's what the emulator reads, so let's open that back up. And go to Mario Kart. Open that up. Okay. And like I said before, we didn't tell it what it was, so it's going to give us this error message again. It's slightly different, but it means the same thing. So we have to go back and remember what file type it was. And we're going to get that. Okay. We're going to get our emulator back open and tell it what file type. We're going to go to Options. And down here at the bottom, the second to last one, you can insert what file type it was. And this has all the file types. If it's not listed, sometimes if you get one similar, it works anyway. Just like here, I don't have the exact file type in this little scroll, so I enter in one just like it. We're going to reset the cartridge, which in the emulator terms means we're literally turning off the game and turning it back on. And as you can see, we have, give it a second to load, Mario Kart DS, just like we wanted. This is the actual game, and it saves you the crap load of money you have to use to buy the DS and buy the game, and I didn't spend any money here. I spent about 3 days trying to figure out the process to do this, and I hope I saved you a lot of time, about 10 minutes. But that's really all there is to it. Kind of upsets me. That's all there is to it, because it took me. You have no idea how long it took me to figure this out, and I'm sure half of you were laughing at me because you already knew how. But anyway, I'll start the game up for you so you can see I'm not like lying or something. This is the actual Nintendo DS. I have the touchscreen on the bottom, and the actual screen on the top. Okay, right here I'm just turning off the sound because it makes the game run a little faster. Alright, and that's all there is to it. Be sure to watch the rest of my videos and subscribe if you like me. Thanks for watching. I feel like a hero, and you my hero. I'm proud.